So just make sure.
But with today's wintry weather, the patches had to stay put.
By 9 minutes.
At this point, it feels like Mother Nature is.
Good.
We're back to snow and ice.
Good.
Cleanup, that means plows are pulling up.
Good.
Our little patchers sit parked. And you forget about the calendar.
Good.
Because here, there will definitely be two more weeks.
Good.
Of winter.
We're in snow and ice operations.
Good.
So we're not anticipating, you know, patching up anything other than.
Good.
Some real major potholes in all the area.
Good.
The same goes for Minneapolis. Spring patching and street sweeping.
Good.
Started today. But now, this is the only sweeping that will be happening until April 16th. And the potholes aren't exactly waiting around. The best the city can do is a temporary fix until the weather allows for hot.
Good.
We'll do at least 100 a week or so, and then with asphalt, we could be about 200 a day filling potholes.
Until that happens, it's even more important to report any spots in need of an urgent fix.
Good.
Cities like Minneapolis, as well as counties and MnDOT, all offer easy ways to report potholes online.
And we do take a look at those every day.
Good.
A 1,000 miles of roadway, and that's what makes all the difference in our ability to treat our roads. Because we find our most needed streets by request.
Good.
If a pothole damages your vehicle, you can file a claim with the state or local agency responsible for maintaining it. But keep in mind, claims are rarely paid because they must prove the agency was negligent.
Yeah.
That's what your best bet.
They won't pay.
Report a problem.
Good.
Other news tonight, 3 people are dead, including a 2-year-old child after a long way crash.
Good.
Interstate 35 in Duluth. Happened about 1 a.m. this morning.
Good.
Went to the State Patrol. 23-year-old Duluth man was driving a Toyota 4Runner the wrong way, the southbound lanes of I-35, when he hit a Yukon head off. The driver of Yukon, a 26-year-old, Rhonda Robinson of Duluth, and a 2-year-old girl were killed.
Aww.
So was the driver of the 4Runner. 3 other passengers sustained non-life-threatening injuries.
Good.
The State Patrol believes how.
Good. Oh, sorry, I shouldn't have gotten that
one. A Winona man is accused of stealing a semi tractor, then leading police on a 50-mile, hour-long chase and ramming a police car.
Good.
According to a criminal complaint, the driver was traveling at speed of nearly 70 miles an hour.
Wow, he needs to get a fast car.
To run a
he was in a semi.
Deployed a taser.
He stole a semi.
Out of the vehicle.
Good.
This is 4 felony charges, including assault.
Good.
Never mind.
Well, starting today, Minneapolis police will learn how to administer a drug that saves people who are overdosing on the internet. The department will train all 125 officers in the 3rd precinct on how to administer naloxone. The 3rd precinct has the highest concentration of overdoses. Last year, police responded there to 200.
All right, good job. All done.
All done.
Yeah, I know. All done.